Hey, you there. I can see you on the cameras. I am so happy to see you. And I need your help with something. Wait, can you even hear me? Hello? Listen, if you can hear what I'm saying, wave at any camera. Oh, thank God. I'm so glad you're here. I thought this was the end. I was looking around and walked into the security room. Then the door closed behind me and I've been stuck inside since. It needs a light blue key card to open, but I don't have it. I know why you're here and I can help you, but you've got to get me out of here. If I recall correctly, only maintenance workers held the light blue key card. So you're gonna have to go down to the maintenance room and look there. The door there is probably locked as well, and I can't open it from here, but I do have control over the break room door. Here, I open it for you. See if you can find anything useful in there. Oh, the good old drones. I lost mine a couple weeks ago. Maintenance workers used them for all sorts of things, like reaching high places and grabbing things that fell into the abyss, and sometimes even comfort. It's good that you have one. It might be useful in our little conundrum. Take a look around and see if you can figure out how to get into the maintenance room. I'm unsure if it can be of much help, but wave at the cameras if you need my insight. My memory is a little fuzzy, but I do remember something about management allowing workers with good scores to punch in later than those with worse scores. The better your performance, the later you're allowed to punch in. This was to encourage workers with lower scores to come earlier and perform better. Naturally, this meant that the person with the lowest score would be punching in first. To make sure that this was always the case, a system was set up to only allow the workers to punch in the perfect order that assumes that nobody is going to be late. Yeah, this system wasn't very well liked. Three birds with one stone. I get all of your key cards, I get the perfect specimen, and I don't have to deal with that thing down there. And it's all thanks to you. Oh, come on. I didn't eat you that hard. Or maybe I did. Either way, it's best you take a nap while I prepare for our little surgery.
I want you all to welcome our newest student. You're late to class. I'll let it slide this time since it's your first day, but be late again and I'll rip you to pieces. You're new and unpopular student, so you will have to sit with the unpopular table in the middle. Now sit, so we can begin. Sit. Okay, class, so the first lesson of the day is math. Over the course of the semester, you will learn how to annihilate others, how to safely extract the human brain for eating, and... Oh, wait, I made a mistake. I think that's lesson 4 of the day. For math, over the course of the semester, you will learn to add, subtract, divide, multiply, and so much more. I am so excited! Before we start, let's revise some of the basics. What is 6874123612 plus 98193912? And remember, wrong answers will be very harshly punished. 7856063524. Correct! You kids are really paying attention today. Next question, and one that I wrote myself. What is 2 plus 2?
4.
Correct! Wow, I thought everyone would get it wrong. Alright, last question before your lunch break. What is misery plus disappointment?
My life.
Correct! Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for math for the day. Go to your lunch break, and then we'll start the next lesson when you come back.
Attention everyone, this announcement concludes your lunch break. Please return to your classes. Also, teachers, please keep in mind that we're on the lookout for a very, very naughty student, believed to be accompanied by a drone. If you catch them, call Principal Banban's office immediately.
Hey, you didn't see the person they're talking about, did you? Oh, what am I saying? You're one of the cool kids. Of course you don't talk to ugly, unpopular kids like them. Take a seat with the cool kids, where you belong. Okay, kids, the next lesson is science. Like we did for math, and since this is the first science lesson of the semester, it will only be a review lesson. But first, let me introduce you to our classroom rules. No eating, no talking, no breathing, no moving, no asking questions, and no washroom breaks. Remember, I will have to punish you very, very harshly if you break any of those rules. Back to the review. Let's start with something easy. How hot is the sun?
Nothing's as hot as me.
I'll allow it, but only because it made me laugh and because you're a cool kid. I can tell by your very cool glasses. Next question. How many hearts does an octopus have?
Stinger flip.
Correct. That's half right, since Stinger Flint is close to an octopus. He's a jellyfish. But I'll allow it, since you're a cool kid. Normal octopuses have 3 hearts. We humans have 1,
And Stingerflynn has... I'm not sure, actually, but let's move on. Next question. We have 5 senses. Sight, smell, taste, touch, and... Correct! Oh, you just made me use my 5th sense. Close enough. I'll allow it. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for science for today. Go on to your second break, and then we'll start the next lesson when it's over.
Attention everyone, this announcement concludes your second break. Please return to your classes.
Oh wow, 3 new kids in one day? 1 unpopular kid? Yuck. 1 cool kid, and 1 mean kid. Welcome! Sit on the table to your left, where you belong, so we can begin. Okay, kids, the next lesson is health and kindness. Just like we did for math and science, it will only be a review lesson. Let's start with some common knowledge to freshen your stupid brains. Can anyone here give me an example of an unkind person?
I will beat you to death.
Correct! That is a perfect example. Good job! Assuming it wasn't directed at me, of course. Now, this time, can anyone give me an example of a kind person?
I will give you immense pain.
Correct! Exactly! Giving others things without expecting anything in return is exactly what kindness is. This class is going to be great! I can feel it! Wait, what was that? I wonder if it's a new student. Nobody move while I check it out. Hello?
Thank you.
You know, on a normal day, you'd be standing where I am, behind the safety of this glass. Like you're in a zoo watching some animals. Speaking of zoos, it's almost assembly time, where all the doors open, so we must keep this brief. Look, I'm sorry I hit you, but you gotta understand. I needed something from you that I could only get if you were unconscious, and I was all out of sedatives. If you'd seen me, you wouldn't have trusted me, I know it. But there was one thing I didn't lie to you about, and that's me knowing why you're here. You're here for your children. I too am working towards saving them, if you can believe it. But someone else has them. Someone far stronger than you and me both, that resides deep in the abyss. Oh no, you've gotta go. There's an elevator in Opilabird's walkway. Take it and we'll talk again down there.
You've been a bad student.
Glad to see you've made it. I don't know how you did it, but then again, you survived a giant elevator crash, so I guess I shouldn't be surprised. Also, again, I apologize for hitting you over the head. In fact, it is for this reason that I believe we should not meet face to face. You see, for whatever reason, I'm prone to violent instincts, and I do not trust myself to not give in to them again. I have locked myself inside of a surveillance room. That way I can help without being a danger to you. We are currently on the lowest floor to remain active before everything went awry. There are many floors below us, but they've all remained closed and abandoned for quite some time now. So just make sure not to fall. As for your children, I don't know exactly where they're being kept, but I know someone who does. Head to the aquatic sector. That's where he resides.
It just hit me that you need the keycard to operate the cable car. Shouldn't be too hard to find one. Literally everyone had a copy. It's how you'd get from station to station.
You've had a rough day, I can tell. You diligently wait for the moment you leave this wretched place with your child in hand, I can also tell. Not to undermine your efforts, but I fear that moment may never come. I cannot let it happen, and I will gladly show you why, but after I do, you take my advice. Leave this place while you still can. Erase it from your memory. Move on and forget any of this ever happened, and I promise you, tomorrow will be a better day. Welcome to my home. Or at least, what was supposed to be my home. Down in the dark and cold depths of the facility, the circumstances force you to do things that are out of your nature. When I feel that I'm straying too far off my original course, I head to the room you have found me meditating in to mentally reboot. I come to this place. And then I am reminded that what I'm fighting for is worth all of this pain and suffering. Of course, none of this is real, but it all could be. I have never had actual sun rays touch my skin. Can you imagine that? And I yearn for the day that they finally do. I need the children to achieve that, but do not worry. I will practice the safest of procedures. Whatever I decide to do with the adults, I will make sure to keep one alive and sane so that the surviving children are delivered to the surface safe and sound. And of course, to deliver me to where I choose to be. Oh, to live the simple life of a completely brainless jellyfish. Just munching on shrimp and avoiding getting eaten by turtles all day. You never appreciate how calming it is to have no conscience until you have one. I admire your courage, so I am giving you the chance to walk away. Take it. That way you won't lose both your life and the chance to see your child.
No liver, no intestines, but most importantly, no pancreas. You, sir, need to have more organs. What am I supposed to eat when there's nothing to eat? Guess I'm going to have to look elsewhere.
Thank you. You are not one of them. You are new.
You need to hide. They are coming.
What happened to you is one of Stinger Flynn's tricks. He left for the progressive sector, but we have something more important to deal with right now. See Nab-Nab's room? It's open now, which means he's inside. He's on the hunt, and it's too dangerous to do anything in this state. We have to deal with him. Luckily, I have a solution, but you won't like it. Head to the medical sector and we'll talk there. When Nab-Nab escaped, it wasn't long before workers started to disappear. Of course, precautions and training can only get you so far, so we had to think of a more permanent solution. Nabnalina was that solution. We had a theory that Nab-Nab was as aggressive as he was due to his loneliness. We never got to prove this theory right, as the collapse happened during the surgery. That's where you come in. You'll be carrying out the final steps of said surgery. Givanium-related procedures are very delicate, so I'm going to need you to pay very close attention to these instructions. The hard part is already done. All you need to do is mix the right concentrations and inject her with it about 6 times? The machine with the droplet symbols is where that's done. When it's time, the screen will light up with the symbol of the needed concentration. For simplicity, the concentrations have been represented by colors. Mix and achieve the right concentration, then collect it in the syringe and give it to Nabnalina. The machine with the colored pipes will occasionally shift to the wrong colors, and when that happens, use the given tongs to revert them all to their normal state of green. The buttons on the walls will also malfunction at times. When that happens, hit any ones that are lit with your drone. The excess Givanium that you can find in the room will deplete when anything malfunctions or when a concentration is needed to be delivered. The procedure stops if any of the four depletes completely, and what happens next is never good. Only the best of us perform Givanium procedures, but we don't have much of a choice. Good luck. hope that wasn't too hard. Anyway, grab the audio disc and head back to the aquatic sector and play it on the big speaker in the lounge. Time for a spider union. At last, he's no longer miserable. I'm surprised they both weren't originally members of the mutants below. They'd certainly fit. This is...
You have overstayed your welcome here. I even made you an offer, but guess what? Accepting it is long overdue. Don't worry, I won't get rid of you or collect you just yet. I was never one to abide by waste. An old friend needs you a lot more than I do. They too are on a path to achieve peace of mind. I already have more than enough subjects to move forward with my aspirations and my ultimate mental refinement. You just take a little nap while I transfer you to where you're meant to be.
Hey you. You're finally awake. Can't blame you for taking a nap. Feels like we've been in this car forever. So, Singer, when are we arriving at this place called Beach?
I believe we are lost.
Nice. You had one job and you messed that up somehow.
I am struggling to locate the being who asked for your opinion.
Can you at least put some music on since we're gonna be out here for a while? That's what I'm talking about. Ophila, what do you think about this? Awesome. Captain, what about you? Captain? Okay, decent answer.
Can you stop vocalizing for just 1 second so I can focus on the road?
What do you mean, focus on the road? We've been going in circles for hours. Never trust a jellyfish, am I right, Opila?
If your pathetic mouth utters another infuriating sentence, I will stuff your whole body in one of those stupid party hats on your head.
Finally, you're waking up! I was getting really bored, and that fellow over there isn't much of a talker. Plus, it's scary here. That big green guy keeps checking in on us. I think he believes we're some sort of dolls. We could use that to our advantage to try and escape. He cannot know that we're alive. Every time we move or change something in the room, let's make sure that it's back to the way it was before he checks in on us again. This way, we can inch our way towards escaping, all while he doesn't suspect a thing. In other words, from his point of view, the room must remain unchanged. When he's close, the lights change color, so run back to your chair when the lights change. I don't know where to start though, so you give it a try. Thank you. Sit down! He's coming! No! That's not how the secret club's entrance is supposed to be! Solve this equation. You're right. Maybe
Quick,
now isn't
sit
the best
down.
Time for education.
He's coming.
You
Hand over your pancreas. Hand over your pancreas. Behave or get Banban. Three stones with one bird. Behave or get Banban. Hand over your pancreas. Behave or get Banban. Hand over your pancreas. 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 Behave or get Banban. Behave or get Banban. Hand over your pancreas.
Okay, bird riding is a new one, I'll give you that. What drives you forward so vigorously? I refuse to accept that it's your protective parental instincts. Oh, I know. Someone has given you false hope, promised you what you want when all along they had one thing on their mind, pancreases. At first, I was confused by how everything was going perfectly in your favor, despite you never being here before. And then it hit me. Someone has to have been guiding you. And as with most things, I was right. You did have help. Your friend here has helped me tremendously. Thanks to him, I bore witness to very vital information. What information, you ask? Well, when my turn comes, I will simply prevent myself from turning into what he turned into.
You can run away, but the smell of your pancreas will always draw me to you. Stop it, you two.